الحديث الأربعون
حديث نمبر 40
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال
From أبي هريرة may Allah be pleased with him that he said
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said
مطل الغني ظلم أي تأخير إعطائه المال
The delay or the procrastination of the one who is wealthy for him to delay repayment of the debt is oppression.
وإذا أتبع أحدكم على مليء فليتبع.
If one of you was referred to someone who is wealthy to pay on behalf of him, then on behalf of the one indebted, then let him be referred, let him go to him.
متفق عليه أخرجه البخاري ومسلم.
This is agreed upon, collected by Bukhari and Muslim.
وهذه ميزة المترجم إذا كان يعني عنده علم شرعي.
This is this is the quality of the translator if he knows the legal meaning of what he's translating.
لأن بعض الأشياء لا تترجم حرفيا لابد أن تترجم علميا.
Because some of the things they cannot be translated literally. They have to be translated in a knowledge-based way.
فقط حتى نسعده لأن أخذنا منه 5,000.
Just trying to make me happy because he took 5,000 already.
طيب راوي الحديث هو أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه.
The narrator of the hadith is Abu Huraira. May Allah be pleased with him.
وفي الحديث الأمر بحسن الوفاء.
And in this hadith, the command to be good in repayment.
ومعنى مطل الغني ظلم.
And the meaning here of the delay of repayment of the one who is wealthy, who has the money, is oppression.
يحتمل أمرين.
It could mean two things, two matters.
إما أن يكون الغني هو الذي اقترض.
Either the one who's the wealthy here is the one who took the loan.
يعني مثلا أنا اقترضت من أخي عبد المنعم مثلا 5,000.
For instance, he took from me a loan of 5,000.
وأنا الآن عندي أموال كثيرة.
And now he has money, he has a lot of money.
ولا أعطيه ماله.
And yet I don't give him back his money.
فهذا معنى مطل الغني ظلم. يعني تأخير الغني أن يدفع المال ظلم.
So for the meaning, this is the first meaning that the one who has the money, who is wealthy, and he can pay, yet he is delaying the payment, the repayment. This is an act of oppression.
يقول أنت غني لماذا لا ترد له ماله؟
So you are wealthy, you can do it. Why are you not repaying him his money?
والمعنى الثاني
the second meaning
أن يكون هو الغني
that the one who is يعني
عبد المنعم
that myself I am the one who is wealthy
وأنا أخذت منه 5,000
and he took from me a loan of 5,000
وأستطيع أن أردها
and he can repay me back
لكني لا أردها
but I do not return it
وإذا قيل لي لماذا لا تردها
if I say to him if it is said to him why are you not giving him back his money
أقول عنده مئات الآلاف هو لا يحتاج إليه
I say he has then he will say oh he has thousands of dollars he doesn't need me to repay him
فهذا مطل الغني أي أن الفقير هو الذي يمطل الغني لا يرد إليه حقه.
So again now the delay here is on the part of the supposedly the poor now he doesn't want to repay the rich his rightful money claiming that oh he has so much money I'm not giving him back.
وهذا يجعل كثيرا من الأغنياء يمتنعون من المساعدة.
And this actually makes a lot of wealthy people refrain from helping people.
لأنه يرى أن هؤلاء لا يردون إليهم أموالهم التي اقترضوها.
Because they will see the wealthy, they will see that those people they don't return back the money that they took.
وإذا قلنا مطل الغني ظلم أن الغني هو المقترض.
الصورة هذه موجودة كثيرا هنا يا
والله صحيح الله المستعان
I was telling the sheikh that this form يعني of a deal is a lot here يعني that's why يقولون الغني يقول يعطي يقول نعطيه صدقة ما أعطيه أنا ما أسلف
لأن لا يرد
لأنها لن ترجع يقول لن ترجع many people who have money they say if I give you something I will give you as a صدقة I will not give you as a loan because I know it will never come back to me I witnessed a lot of things like that unfortunately I'm sure you're smiling. The same thing happened to many of you.
إذا منطوق الحديث أن الغني لا يجوز له أن يمتنع عن دفع الأموال للناس.
So the direct wording of the hadith, it says that the one who has the money, the wealthy one, he should not be delaying the repayment, the rights of the people.
ومفهومه.
And we understand from it
أن المعسر لا إثم عليه.
We understand from it by way of indication now that the one who actually is not wealthy, he doesn't have the money, he's in financial trouble, then there is no sin against him because he doesn't have it.
أما من يغتصب أموال الناس,
as for the one who forcibly يعني takes the money of the people,
أو يسرقها أو يجحدها,
or steals them or takes them and denies them,
فهؤلاء,
so those,
يلزمهم أن يردوا للناس حقوقهم.
It is a must upon them that they have to return back to the people their rights.
ولو خسروا ما خسروا.
Even if they lose whatever they lose.
يعني عندما مثلا يسرق أرضا.
For instance, someone steals a piece of land.
ويبني عليها بيتا.
And he builds a house on it.
ثم إذا قيل له أرجع الأرض إلى صاحبها.
Then when he is told, give back the piece of land to the rightful owner.
فيقول أنا الآن بنيت بيتا.
He says, I built a house on it now.
يهدم البيت.
The house is to be destroyed, يعني demolished.
ولذلك قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
ليس لعرق ظالم حق.
There is no there is no right for the efforts or the labor, the sweat of an oppressor. There is no right for him, even if he labored hard and sweat for it, because this is part of oppressing the people.
وفي الجملة الأخرى يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن أحيل إلى مليء فليحتل. يعني إذا كان الآن نحن ثلاثة.
In the other statement here, the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, if you are referred to someone who has the money to pay, then you should go to him.
ما اسمك؟
رشيد.
نعم. الآن أنا ورشيد والشيخ عبد المنعم الآن.
So
ثلاثة.
We are three. رشيد, myself, and the Sheikh.
رشيد, أنا أطلبه $1,000.
So the Sheikh wants, يعني he's right, is $1,000 from Rashid.
وشيخ عبد المنعم يريد مني $500.
And I want from him. يعني he owes me. يعني I want $500 from the Sheikh.
دين.
He owes me. دين. He owes me a debt for $500.
فيقول لي أعطني الخمسمائة.
So I say to him, give me my $500.
أنا أقول خذها من رشيد.
So he tells me, go to Rashid and take it from him.
فهذا هي الحوالة.
This is what is called حوالة, referral. Referral.
من أحيل إلى مليء. يعني إلى غني.
I was referred by him to someone who is مليء. Mali literally means filled, but it means he has something to pay. He has money.
لكن لو كان رشيد فقيرا.
But if Rashid was poor,
فماذا يستفيد عبد المنعم؟
What do I benefit if I was referred to him? He's the opposite of filled is empty.
لا تصح الحوالة. لا تصح.
So this referral that he did is not valid then.
فلا بد أن أحيله على مليء باذل.
He
يعني
must
عنده ويعطيه.
He must refer me to someone who has the money, who's يعني his pockets are filled, and he is willing to offer. He is willing to pay.
لكن لو أرسلته إلى رشيد ورشيد قال أنا لا ما عندي شيء.
But if he sends me to Rashid and Rashid says I don't have anything to
أو
give
أن رشيد عنده لك قال لا أريد أن أعطيه.
Or Rashid actually does have the money but he says you know what I'm not gonna give you the.
فهنا يرجع إليه.
So then in this case I come back to the Sheikh.
لكن إذا كان رشيد عنده
but
ويعطيه.
If Rashid has the money and he's willing to give it,
يجب عليه أن يقبل.
It is a must upon me to accept this referral from the Sheikh.
لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ومن أحيل إلى مليء فليحتل أو فليتحول.
Then the one who is referred to someone who is wealthy, who has the money to pay, then let him accept the referral.
وهذا من المسامحة في المعاملة.
And this is from the nice way of dealing, you know, making financial deals.
ولذلك قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Liberality and courtesy in dealings.
نعم. وإذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
رحم الله رجلا.
May Allah have mercy on a person and on a man who is kind and nice when he is when he sells and when he buys and when he asks for his money back. This is narrated by Bukhari in his Sahih. The opposite of that, the one who is difficult and not easy.
ويزعج الناس بهذا لا يرضى أن يتحول.
He bothers the people with in this dealing. He doesn't, for instance, accept to be referred. I don't want to be referred to so and so.
والله أعلم.
And Allah knows best.
ونقف هنا.
Yeah, we stop here, inshallah.
صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا.
جزاك الله خيرا يا شيخ. كنا نأخذ بعض الأسئلة. نعم.
تفضل.
قل ذكرت أن السيئات لا تتضاعف فكيف يكون في الأشهر الحرم هل تتضاعف أم يكون كغيره من الشهور. You mentioned that the evil deeds are not multiplied, so how would it be in the inviolable sacred months? Are the sins multiplied or it will be like the other months?
السيئة لا تتضاعف بالعدد.
The evil deed is not multiplied in terms of a number.
واحدة بواحدة.
One is for one. One evil deed is just one.
لكن تتضاعف بالكيف.
But it will be multiplied in terms of the how.
كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى.
As Allah تبارك وتعالى said.
عن الحرم.
From about the haram.
ومن يرد فيه بإلحاد بظلم نذقه من عذاب شديد.
The one who intends to commit by deviation, by committing oppression in it, then we will make him taste, we shall make him taste a painful torment. So the multiplication here is in the how, not in the number. ما هو حكم الذين يقولون بأنهم عرب وهم في الأصل ليس كذلك؟
لا لا لا
هو طويل السؤال
بعد
من مصر يعني يقول فراعنة إلى الغرب بربر وفي الغرب والجزائر أظن يقصد لا يزالون يتكلمون بغير العربية وكلبنان يعني الروم يقول أيضا حتى صفاتهم تشبه الأجانب شعر أصفر عيون زرقاء فهل يكفرون فهل هم كافرون. الجواب بصراحة التاريخ يشهد بأن العرب هم أهل اليمن والعراق وشبه الجزيرة العربية ما عدا ذلك فهم يدعون فهل هم كافرون المسلمين منهم ليس كل العرب مسلمين. يقول what is the ruling about those who say that they are Arabs when they are not like that. Egypt, they are originally pharaohs, he's saying, the ones in the Western Arabs countries, they are actually Berber or barbarian, the root, the lineage, not the lineage, not the, you know, not the word, يعني, the meaning. Also in Maghreb, Morocco, Algeria, they are still talking in other than the Arabic language. Lebanese, they're like the Romans. They even look like them, blue eyes and yellow, blonde hair. Are they disbelievers? I want the answer frankly, because history testifies that the Arabs are the people of Yemen, Iraq, and the Arabian Peninsula. And other than that, they only claim. So are they disbelievers? Those Muslims amongst them, are they disbelievers? Because not all Arabs are Muslims.
أيوة أظن يشبه عليه حتى موضوع الكفر يعني.
يكفرون. أولا الكفر هنا ليس الكفر المخرج من الملة.
First of all, the disbelief here in terms of denying the lineage is not the disbelief that takes one outside of Islam.
وإنما هذا مثل الطعن في الأنساب والنياحة.
This is like
غيرها من أعمال الكفار ولا يكون كافرا الإنسان بهذا.
Defaming the lineages of the people. And the wailing, for instance, that's called kufr, but it does not mean outside of Islam. It's just يعني mentioning that it is a bad sin, evil sin.
وليس فيه أيضا أنه من قال أنا عربي وليس بعربي فإنه كافر.
There isn't in the hadith that the one who said I am Arab and he is not Arab, then he is a kafir, meaning a disbeliever. There isn't a hadith like this.
وإنما الحديث فيه من انتسب إلى غير أبيه. أو انتسب إلى غير قومه.
Rather, the hadith says the one who attributes himself in lineage to other than his father, parent, to other his than his tribe, then he has disbelieved.
أما العروبة وغير العروبة.
Being Arab or non-Arab, Arabism or non-Arabism.
فهناك أولا من اشتهر بالانتساب إليهم بالولاء.
First of all, there are those who are famous for being attributed to the Arab by what is called al-wala.
مثل تسمع أو تقرأون في الكتب كثيرا.
Like you read in the books a lot.
الجعفي ولاء.
الجعفي.
مثل البخاري.
ولاء. Like البخاري.
الجعفي هو ليس جعفيا.
He is not جعفي.
قبيلة عربية.
جعفي is this is an Arabic tribe, but he is referred to them. But he is not actually from them, but it is by what is called al-wala. Inshallah, the Sheikh will explain al-wala.
يعني هذا كان العبيد.
So the slaves.
بعد الجهاد وكذا.
After like the wars and the likes of that.
فينتسبون إلى مواليهم. من يملكونهم.
The slaves they will be attributed to their owners.
وهذا مأذون فيه شرعا.
This is what is called al-wala. This is allowed Islamically speaking.
وقضية العروبة
the issue of being Arab or Arabism
ليس فيها فضل بحيث أن الإنسان ينتسب إلى العرب يكون له فضل في هذا.
There isn't like an excellence in a way that if one attributes himself to the Arabs then he becomes better.
إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم.
The most noble amongst you are the most pious with Allah.
ولكن المسألة هذه مسألة تاريخية.
This issue is a historical matter.
وإذا يعني أردنا أن ننظر في تفاصيل هذا الأمر
if we want to look into the details of this affair
فأهل السير والتراجم
the people who wrote biographies and the lifetimes of people
يقسمون العرب إلى ثلاثة أقسام
they categorize the Arabs to three categories
يقول عرب بائدة
عرب بائدة Arabs who perished
وعرب باقية
Arabs who remained
وعرب مستعربة
and Arab who became Arabized
ويقولون عن العرب البائدة الذين هم قوم هود وقوم صالح
they say
وقوم
about
شعيب.
The Arabs that perished the people of هود صالح and شعيب
الذين أهلكهم الله
those whom Allah destroyed
هذه يسمونها عرب بائدة.
Those are the Arabs that have been destroyed or perished.
ولا يوجد لهم ذرية الآن.
They have no descendants now. No children. No progeny.
قالوا عرب باقية.
They said Arabs that remained.
وهم جرهم وجديس وغيرهم.
These tribes that the Sheikh mentioned.
وهم الذين تزوج منهم إسماعيل عليه الصلاة والسلام.
These are the ones whom إسماعيل got married to a woman from them.
من جرهم.
From جرهم.
فيقول هؤلاء من العرب الباقية.
So those are the Arabs that remained.
وهم العرب الذين ليسوا من ذرية إسماعيل.
They are the Arabs who are not from the progeny. They are not from the descendants of Ismail himself.
والعرب المستعربة هم ذرية إسماعيل عليه السلام.
As for the Arabs who are described as Arabized became Arab, they are the children of Ismail.
أو لأن إسماعيل هو ابن إبراهيم عليه السلام.
They said because إسماعيل is the son of Ibrahim عليه السلام.
وإبراهيم قالوا ليس بعربي.
إبراهيم.
آشوري.
They said he is not Arab, he is Ashuri.
ف فقالوا ذرية إسماعيل يقال لهم عرب مستعربة.
So the children, the descendants of Ismail, they are called Arab who became Arab, Arabized.
أي لم يكونوا أصلا من العرب وإنما تعربوا.
In origin they are not Arabs, but then they became as such, they became Arabs.
ومنهم الرسول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And amongst them from the messengers is محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وجل القبائل العربية الموجودة الآن.
And most of the Arab tribes that exist now, they are from those.
وهناك من يقول إن إبراهيم أصوله عربية.
And there are those who say that Ibrahim, his roots are Arab.
وبغض النظر عن هذا.
يعني putting يعني disregarding this issue,
الناس كلهم أبناء نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام.
The people, all of them, are the children of نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام.
لأن نوح يقال له آدم الثاني.
Because نوح is titled the second Adam.
لأن الله تبارك وتعالى يقول وجعلنا ذريته هم الباقين.
Because Allah سبحانه وتعالى says we made his descendants, his progeny, to be the ones who remain. Stay.
فقضية الانتساب للعرب أو عدم انتساب للعرب هذا فيها كلام كثير.
So being attributed by lineage to the Arab or not, this a lot of talk.
بس أهم شيء لا ينتسب إلى رجل يعرف أنه ليس أبا له.
The most important thing is that you do not attribute yourself in lineage to a man whom you are not really attributed.
ولا ينتسب. ولا ينتسب إلى عائلة يعلم أنه ليس ولدا لهم.
You don't attribute yourself to a family knowing that you don't belong in their children.
ولا ينتسب إلى قبيلة يعرف أنه ليس منهم.
You do not attribute yourself to a tribe knowing that you are not from that tribe.
هذا هو المنهي عنه.
This is what is prohibited.
وما قضية العرب غيرها ليس فيها فضل.
As for the issue of the Arabs and other than that, then there is no excellence in that.
وإذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
لو كان الإيمان في الثريا.
If iman was in the star called الثريا, if iman was there, faith or belief.
لنا له رجال من فارس.
Then men from Persia will attain and achieve that. We'll grasp that. هل يجوز هل لا يجوز البيع والشراء مع السفيه أي الرشد صحة في المعاملات التجارية. Is it not allowed to buy and sell with someone who is سفيه weak foolish or feeble minded in transactions commercial transactions? Is it meaning that being wise or being not foolish is a condition? هل هذا شرط؟
واضح. بالنسبة للصغير والسفيه.
In the case of the young and the foolish.
يجوز البيع والشراء في الأشياء اليسيرة.
It is allowed for them to conduct sales in issues matters that are small.
مثل الطفل يشتري له مثلا حليبا أو يشتري
like a child
بسكويت أو شيء
buying milk or biscuits or something.
لكن لا يشتري سيارة, لا يشتري أرض, لا يشتري بيت.
A child doesn't buy a car or you know something like that.
لأنه يمكن أن يغش في هذا.
Because he may be cheated in this.
إما لصغره.
Either because he is so young in age.
وإما لعدم حسن تصرفه.
Or because he doesn't know how to manage and how to deal.
وهذا الذي يقال له السفيه.
And this is the one who is titled سفيه or foolish. He doesn't know
الله
how to manage.
وتعالى.
Because of the statement of Allah Ta'ala.
ولا تؤتوا السفهاء أموالكم.
Do not give the سفهاء, the foolish, your money.
نعم. والمقصود أموالهم هم.
وسماها
أموالكم لأن أنتم القائمون عليها.
What is meant here, do not give them your wealth, your money. What is meant actually is the money of the foolish actually. That is what is meant in the ayah. But since you are responsible for the money that belongs to the foolish, then do not give them your wealth because they don't know how to manage.
وفي الآية الأخرى وابتلوا اليتامى.
And the other ayah says and test the examine the orphans
حتى إذا بلغوا النكاح
up until they reach the age of marriage
فإن آنستم منهم رشدا فادفعوا إليهم أموالهم.
So if they sense that they reached an age where they can discern, they are wise to deal, then give them their monies.
ومفهومها
And we understand from this
أنك لا تعطيه المال إذا لم يكن رشيدا.
That if he is not rashid, if he doesn't know how to manage, then we understand from that that don't give them then if they are not able to manage. بيع الأجل. فلان بيع تاني في بيعة. يعني يقول بعض المشايخ أجازوا الأجل والبعض لم يجز. بيع الأجل وقالوا أنه ربا وبيع تاني في بيعة ما إلى ذلك يعني. Some scholars they said that selling with installments is riba if you increase the price and they considered it to be two sales in one sale but other scholars they said that it is okay to differ to, for the price to be different if it's cash or deferred. تفضل يا شيخ.
جماهير أهل العلم.
The majority of the people of knowledge.
يقولون بجواز بيع الأجل ولو مع الزيادة.
They say it's allowed to buy over time even if you increase the price.
فيقول له أبيعك هذه cash. السيارة so نقدا says, بعشرة آلاف.
So he says I sell you this car cash $10,000
وإذا كنت ستدفعها أقساطا فأبيعها بأحد عشر ألفا
and if you are going to pay on by installments over time then I will sell it to you for 11,000
لأنك ستضرني وتؤخرني
because you're going to harm me and you're going to delay me the payment
فجماهير أهل العلم على جواز هذا البيع
so the overwhelming majority of the people of knowledge they are upon the position that it is allowed to sell like that
واختار الإمام الألباني رحمه الله تعالى
and the Imam Albani رحمه الله تعالى he chose
إلى أن هذا البيع لا يجوز
that this type of selling is not allowed
وقال هذا يصدق عليه قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه نهى عن بيعتين في بيعة
and he said that this actually the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is true regarding this type of a sale that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade two sale contracts in just one contract
والجمهور جمهور العلماء على خلاف ذلك
and the majority of the scholars they are upon other than this
ويقولون معنى قوله بيعتين في بيعة
they say the meaning of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم two sales in one sale
هو ألا يتفق على إحدى البيعتين
is that the buyer and the seller they don't agree on one of on either one of the two
فيقول له هذا الهاتف
so he says to him this phone
بألف نقدا
is $1,000 cash
بألف ومئتين مقسطا
and 1,200 over installments over time
فيقول له صاحبه اتفقنا
so the buyer says okay we agree
اتفقنا على ماذا
we agree on what
أنه نقدا أو مقسطا
that it is cash or installments
هذه هي البيعتين
they this is two sales
انه لم يتفق على احداهما
they did not agree on either one of the two
لان هذه تحدث الخصومات بين الناس
because this brings disputes and quarrels between the people
فلو فرضنا ان المشتري
so if we suppose that the buyer
تاخر في دفع المبلغ
got delayed in paying the money
وجاءه بعد أربعة أشهر
and he came to him after four months
وأعطاه ألفا
and he gave him 1,000
قال لا أنا بعتك مقسطا 1,200
he said no I sold you with installments it should be 1,200
يقول لا أنا اشتريته نقدا بألف لكني تأخرت
he says no I bought it cash for 1,000 but I'm just late in paying
هذه توقع الخصومة بينهما
this brings disputes between
أو العكس
or the opposite
يأتيه بعد مدة ويعطيه 100 دينار
And he comes to him after a while. He gives him $100.
يقول أين الباقي؟
He says, where is the rest of the money?
يقول أنا اشتريتها مقسطا.
He says, I bought it from you by installments.
يقول له صاحب لا أنا بعتك نقدا.
He says to him, no, I sold you in cash.
فهما لم يحسما البيعة.
So they did not determine the sale, how it's going to be.
فهذا معنى بيعتين في بيعة.
This is the meaning of two sales in one.
أما ما اختاره الإمام الألباني رحمه الله تعالى.
As for what Imam Al-Albani chose, رحمه الله.
وأنه ولو بينا واتفق على إحدى البيعتين. هذا.
Even though they clarified and they agreed on how they're gonna do it, that still it's not allowed.
فقوله غير صحيح.
This is his position is incorrect.
والصحيح ما ذهب إليه أكثر أهل العلم.
And the correct position is what the majority of the scholars took.
وأن هذا جائز والله
أعلم. That this is allowed and Allah knows best.
وهكذا فسر الحديث راويه.
And this is how the narrator of the hadith, the tabi'i, he explained this hadith this way.
نعم.